Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to demonstrate a feature in Photoshop that tends to be overlooked by the average user, and that's the blend if controls. This feature works quite well if you're, let's say, trying to replace the sky of one of your photos. For example, in this photo here, we're going to attempt to replace the boring blue sky with this mountainous background. Now before we start messing with new features, let's analyze this photo for a second by looking at our channels. When looking through our channels, we want to try and find the channels with the darkest and the brightest areas, and you'll see why in a few moments. Looking at the blue channel, we can certainly see it has the darkest areas out of the three channels, especially when it comes to the trees, which is probably our most important focus area. As for the bright areas, our red channel seems to have a nice amount of brightness in the sign. Keep that in mind for later on. I'm going to go ahead and simply drag the mountain photo on top of the photo with the sign and place it where I'd like to show up in the background. Now that that's in place, double-click on the top layer to open up our Layer Styles dialog box. Usually when we're here, it's to add things like outer glows or bevels, but today we're going to stay within the Blending Options section. Down at the bottom we have Blend If, which right now is set to gray. This is where our channel analysis comes into play. Let's change gray to blue. The top bar will affect areas of our current layer, and the bottom bar will affect the layer underneath it. So because we want to keep the top layer intact, we're going to focus on the bottom bar. Now if you remember from a few moments ago on the blue channel, there were a lot of dark areas. Watch what happens when I drag the dark slider to the right. Those areas which fall in this range are starting to appear in front of our image. I'm going to stop when I see the blue from the original sky leak into the image. Now as you can probably tell if I zoom into the leaves, there are a lot of sharp edges, so how do we deal with that? Well, it turns out that this slider is actually made up of two sliders. If you hold down your Alt or Option key and drag the left side out, the slider will split into two. This will allow the colors to transition, giving us a much cleaner result. Now in terms of the sky, it's looking pretty nice, but looking at the building, there are some clear problems. So we're going to use the brightness in the red channel to fix it up. Once changed to red, instead of dragging the dark slider, grab the light slider and drag it over until the blue starts seeping in again, right around 160. Now just like before, we can split the slider to create a nice transition. I'm going to drag it to the right and pop this one around 220. Good, that's looking great. Let's go ahead and accept and take a look at the result. And what's neat about this technique is that you can drag the layer around and it still maintains the blend. But you might notice that the job isn't 100% complete. While the trees are looking really nice, there are some leftover bits on the building. This can easily be taken care of with a layer mask. Once a layer mask is applied, paint over the remaining areas with a black brush. And you're done. If you use this feature properly, the Blend If controls can be very helpful, but it also won't work for everything. But give it a shot and post your results on our Facebook page over at facebook.com/iceflowstudios. Take care.